न्यूज फ्रॉम इंडियन एक्सप्रेस न्यूज़पेपर। BIS प्रिपेयर्स ड्राफ्ट स्टैंडर्ड फॉर वाटर सप्लाई इन स्टेट्स। द ब्यूरो ऑफ इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड्स BIS हैज प्रिपेयर्ड अ ड्राफ्ट स्टैंडर्ड फॉर द ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सप्लाई सिस्टम विच एम्स टू एक्ट एज अ बेंचमार्क फॉर मेंटेनिंग वाटर क्वालिटी एंड डेवलपिंग अ यूनिफॉर्म प्रोसेस फॉर स्टेट्स ऑप्टिंग टू इम्प्लीमेंट इट। BIS official said that the draft standard has been developed keeping in view the center's Jal Jeevan mission for providing safe and adequate drinking water to all rural households by 2024 through individual tap connections. A standard was already placed for drinking water as a product, but in view of the Jal Jeevan mission should develop a standard that covers all aspects of water supply. The draft mentions that treatment of water and distribution should be done in a manner that ensures that at the customer point distribution, the water quality conforms to the Indian standard IS 10500 developed by the BIS. Quality of drinking water became a contentious issue in November last year when a BIS report released by Union Minister Ram Vilas Paswan found Delhi's tap water quality as the worst among 21 metros and state capitals in the country. News from Indian Express newspaper. Center urges states to firm up own laws to curb flood damage. With flood claiming more than 800 lives and affecting millions in many parts of the country in the ongoing monsoon season, the center has asked state governments to take urgent action for enactment of suitable legislation on lines of the Model Flood Planning Zone Bill 1975. To mitigate damage. ₹3.47 lakh crore estimated damage to crops, houses and public utilities between 1953 and 2016 across India. ₹3.43 lakh crore damage out of this cost from 1975 to 2016. This is or 98% of the total. 10500 people died due to floods from 1953 to 2016. 89,246 lives lost between 1975 and 2016. News from Indian Express newspaper. Bihar will be the first state in the country to go for polls amidst the coronavirus pandemic. According to the Election Commission, the technical staffers dealing with EVMs have reportedly been offered health insurance, particularly after some of them tested positive. Sources said the EC has completed a first level check of EVMs and VVPATs and completed training of returning officers. As per the guidelines issued by the Election Commission, not more than 1,000 voters instead of the usual 1,500 will be assigned to a polling station. Their temperatures would be checked before they are allowed in. If temperature of a voter is above the set norms of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare at first reading, then it will be checked twice, and if it remains high, then the electoral shall be provided with token certificate and will be asked to come for voting at the last hour of poll.
News from the Hindu newspaper. Court allows three Jain temples in Mumbai to open for 2 days with COVID-19 safeguards. A three-judge bench led by Chief Justice of India Sharad A. Bobde said this while allowing a plea by Shri Parshvatilak श्वेतांबर मूर्ति पूजक जैन ट्रस्ट टू कीप टेम्पल्स एट दादर बायकुला एंड चैम्बोर इन मुंबई ओपन फॉर प्रेयर्स ऑन अगस्त 22 एंड 23 फॉर द परशुवन फेस्टिवल. द टेम्पल्स हैव टू फॉलो कोविड 19 प्रिवेंटिव नॉर्म्स इन प्लेस. Chief Justice Bobde remarked only that we find it strange that they are willing to allow activities involving economic interest, but if it is involves religion, they cite COVID to say they cannot open. The observation was triggered by a submission made by senior advocate Dushyant Dave, questioning the policy of the state to open malls, saloons and liquor shops. He said there were long queues in front of liquor shops. He asked if the center was allowing religious to be organized, how could the worshippers at these Jain temples be denied their right to offer worship. The trust was seeking permission for a congregation of 5 at a time, up to 250 people a day. The Chief Justice said at one point, if it is only 5 people, we do not mind going beyond Jain community and allowing same for Hindu, Muslim and other communities too. The Supreme Court put the onus of paying dues linked to adjusted gross revenue AGR. In an observation with the wide ramifications, the Supreme Court put the onus of paying dues linked to the adjusted gross revenue AGR on those telecos which are using the spectrum earlier held by now bankrupt firms. According to the court proceedings, if bankrupt firms fail to pay their AGR dues, the telecom operators that got spectrum from them must make the payment. According to the court proceedings, if bankrupt firms fail to pay their AGR dues, the telecom operators that got spectrum from them must make the payment. The three-judge bench, headed by the Justice Arun Mishra, said the spectrum trading guidelines mandated clearance of past dues before the transfer of the radio airwave to a new buyer under the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code IBC. If the bankrupt company that holds the spectrum does not pay the AGR dues, its users clears the dues, the court said. Referring to the matter of Reliance Jio's liability to pay the AGR dues of Reliance Communications, Justice Mishra noted that the Department of Telecommunications had not shared the details sought by the court. We wanted to ascertain the dues payable by Reliance Jio based on the use of RCOM spectrum. The week of the case was August 17. Supreme Court asked Center whether Jio could be held liable to pay AGR dues of RCOM, a bankrupt firm, seek annual financial details of RCOM as it would be crucial for the judgment on AGR. August 18, Apex Court says no technicality will come in the way of enforcing recovery of levies. August 19, Court says telecom companies only have the right to use spectrum and it is not an asset that belongs to them. August 20, Supreme Court expresses concern over AGR dues melting away in bankruptcy proceedings. August 21, Court says if bankrupt firms fail to pay their dues, payment will be made by operators that bought these companies. What is AGR? The adjusted gross revenue AGR calculation is what the government and telecom majors have had a disagreement over since 2005. The telecom companies argued that AGR should include income only from telecom operations. The Government Department of Telecommunications disagreed and said it should also include non
telecom incomes such as the sale of assets, interest and deposits, rents, etc.
Ventilators from firms funded by PM CARES failed trials. Two firms given purchase order for indigenously manufactured ventilators for COVID-19 treatment funded by PM CARES have failed a clinical evaluation by the Health Ministry's Technical Committee, according to the information accessed through the Right to Information RTI Act. The firm Jyoti CNC Automation and Andhra Pradesh MedTech Zone AMTZ had already received ₹22.5 crore in advance payment in May when the PM CARES allocation was made. However, by July, they were dropped from the list according to the ministry's response to an RTI request filled by activist Anjali Bhardwaj. Jyoti CNC is a Gujarat-based firm whose ventilators were slammed as inadequate for critical COVID-19 patients by the Ahmedabad Civil Hospital. AMTZ is run by the Andhra Pradesh government. Although its ventilators were not included in the list of recommended suppliers post-clinical evaluation, according to the Health Ministry's July 20 response.
News from Indian Express newspaper. NHRC indicated Jamia row handled unprofessionally. Hearing a batch of PILs related to the violence at Jamia Millia Islamia in December last year, the Delhi High Court told the Delhi police that the National Human Rights Commission NHRC report into the violence does not give a clean chit to anyone, and pointed out that the report indicated the incident was not handled professionally. On December 15 last year, anti-CAA protest outside Jamia spiraled into violence, following which security personnel barged into the campus and allegedly assaulted students inside the library. What is NHRC? The National Human Rights Commission of India is a statutory body constituted on 12th of October 1993 under the Protection of Human Rights Ordinance of 28th September 1993. It was given a statutory basis by the Protection of Human Rights Act 1993.
News from the Hindu newspaper. New enrollments in EPFO up by 8.47 lakh in first quarter, says government. The government on Thursday said that the subscriber base of the Employees Provident Fund Organization EPFO has gone up by more than 8.4 lakh during the first quarter, April to June of the current financial year. According to an official release by the Ministry of Labour and Employment, the COVID-19 pandemic had adversely affected the enrollments in the months of April and May. Despite the lockdown, around 0.20 lakh and 1.72 lakh net new subscribers were added to social security schemes of EPFO in April and May respectively. However, in June, EPFO witnessed an addition of 6.55 lakh net subscribers, registering a 280% month-on-month growth. The subscriber base growth is on account of increased number of new subscribers, lower exit and higher rejoining by exited members, the release said.
The RBI governor suggests disconnect between economy and stock market. According to the RBI governor Das, there was a clear disconnect between the sharp surge in stock markets and the state of real economy, as surplus global liquidity was driving up assets prices across the world. The disconnect driven by massive liquidity injected by the central banks was a global phenomena and not peculiar to India. There is a disconnect, and we have spoken about it in our Monetary Policy Committee resolution as well as some of my past speeches. The massive injection of a global liquidity has driven the sharp surge in stock prices, which is definitely disconnected with the real economy.